Hi there. Today we will be solving problem 1.4 from the chapter Vector Algebra. Use the cross product to find the components of unit vector n perpendicular to the shaded plane in the figure below. Now in the figure below, the vertices of the shaded plane are marked and the shaded plane is indicated by the gray lines. We have to find two such vectors whose cross product lies in the plane perpendicular to the shaded plane. Now, if we start with AB and AC, we know that AB cross AC will have a direction given by n cap, where n cap is the unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing AB and AC. So if AB and AC both lie on this shaded plane, then the unit vector would definitely lie along the direction of n. So then finding AB cross AC would solve our problem, and finding a unit vector from there on should be straightforward. So let's go ahead and find the AB cross AC. To know more about the directions of the cross product, this figure is a good reference point, and the right hand rule is generally the best way to find out what exactly is the direction of the vector cross product. So let's go ahead and find the AB cross AC. So what is AB? AB is equals to OB minus OA, which is given by 0x plus 2y plus 0z, we obtain that from here, minus OA, which is 1x plus 0y plus 0z. We obtain OA from here. Now, this definition is from the position vector's definition. So, AB is given by, therefore, 0 minus 1 is minus 1 x, 2 minus 0 is 2 y, 0 minus 0 is 0 z. So AB happens to be minus 1 x, 2 y plus 0 z. Similarly, AC would then be OC minus OA, which is given by, so OC is obtained from this, so 0x plus 0y plus 3z minus A is again here, 1x plus 0y plus 0z. That gives us 0 minus 1 is minus 1x, 0 minus 0 is 0y, and 3 minus 0 is 3z. So AC is given by this. So we know both AB and AC. So AB is minus 1 of x plus 2 of y plus 0 of z, and AC is minus 1 of x plus 0 of y plus 3 of z. We had marked this as 1 and 2. All that we need to do now is find the cross product. We know that the cross product AB cross AC is found by writing unit vectors as the first column of this matrix and then writing the x components under the x and y components under the y and z components under the z for both these vectors. And once we write this down, we have to find the determinant of this particular matrix. once we find the determinant of this matrix, our vector cross product is obtained. Now, let's see how we go about doing that. So, first thing, we'll have to find the x component. So, to find x component, we cut out the x column and row, and then go about finding the x component by multiplying these two. So 2 into 3 is 6 and 0 into 0 is 0. So 6 minus 0, this forms the x component. And then we go ahead and find the y component. We use a minus symbol. So cut out the columns and rows containing the y cap and then find the y component. Minus 1 into 3 is minus 3. Minus 1 into 0 is 0. That's equal to, so minus 3 there. And then finally, we will go about finding the z cap component. So that will be found by using the minus 1 into 0 is 0, minus 2 into minus 1 is minus 2, and this gives us 6x. Minus 3 into minus is plus, so plus 3y, and minus of minus 2 is 2, plus 2z. Hence, AB cross AC is equals to 6x plus 3y plus 2z. From here on, the problem is pretty straightforward. Let's assume this is some vector called P. Then to find the unit vector of P would be to actually divide P by its own magnitude, which here in our case is 6x plus 3y plus 2z is divided by square root of 6 square plus 3 square plus 2 square. This happens to be the magnitude of the vector. Hence, we can find what it is by 6 square plus 3 square plus 2 square is equal to 49, and square root of which is actually 7. We go ahead and find 6x plus 3y plus 2z is divided by 7. Hence, the unit vector would then be 6 by 7x plus 3y by 7 plus 2 by 7z. Now, this happens to be the n vector that we are looking for. Please subscribe to this channel for more videos and problems.